Who's going to look after me now?
Well, I mean, can't they help you?
Oh, if I go running to the screws, I'm a goner for sure.
Sharon, is someone threatening you?
The only way I'm going to be left alone, Jude, is if I've got something to pay them off.
Well, I can get some money, I think. I don't know. How much do you need?
You don't need money in here. It's got to be something stronger, Jude.
Come on, girl. That's why you're in here in the first place.
If you don't help me, Jude, I'm done for.
Okay. How much do you need?
Thanks, Jude.
You ever had a boyfriend, Tracy?
Yeah. Only wanted one thing, though.
No. Kevin's not like that. He never pushed me into anything. You don't reckon that's why he stopped seeing me, do you? He could have got sick of waiting.
Yeah, could have, I suppose.
Oh, no. No, he would have let on. He probably thinks I was just out to get my hooks into him. But if he didn't want to get serious, I wouldn't have cared. It's just good being with him, that's all.
Won't be long.
I thought you were having a sleep.
What, with you two yucking your heads off?
Well, where are you going?
To get some more paint. With the way you're going through it, I ought to buy the shop.
See my sister, Sharon Gilmore.
Visiting hours were over.
Yeah, I know. I rang. They said it was okay. She's sick. Thanks.
What have you got there?
Oh, I don't like leaving it in the car.
Check in with reception.
Thanks.
Long enough to notice,
do you? I certainly hope so. It's the quickest way for him to lose his job. Can I help you?
Yeah, I wanted to see Sharon Gilmore.
Well, visiting hours finished some time ago. Didn't the guard tell you?
Yeah, but I'm her sister.
I'm sorry, whether it's family or friend, it makes no difference. Mrs. Jackson?
As Mrs. Davidson said, sisters don't have any more rights. So there's no need to go on pretending, is there? Come along. I said, come along.
I got a bone to pick with you about Dor.
Yeah, well, I don't want to talk about it, thanks.
You don't want to talk about it? Well, I'll tell them how you kicked your old granny out in the street to rot.
Yeah, well, that was a rotten trick you pulled, Lizzie.
Why? Afraid of what your workmates might think?
No, it's not that. It's just that... Well, yeah, all right, I felt stupid. Come on, sit down.
Look, get this off of me!
It's all right, it's just a beanbag. It's meant to do that. Just
yeah?
Hang on.
Oh! Funny things, aren't they? Beanbags. Looks as though you need a woman's hand around here.
Yeah, well, it's usually made. I just slept late this morning, that's all.
Laid one on, did you?
Yeah, I had a few.
Yeah. Usually when a young man lays one on, it means he's feeling guilty about something.
Well, I'm not feeling guilty about anything.
Well, it must have been something else. Made a mistake, eh?
Look, what's happened between me and Doreen, you know? It's none of your business.
Yeah, what would you know?
Well, I know Doreen. I'd never promised her anything.
If you knew her that well, you'd know that she's breaking her heart. She's blaming herself because you dumped her.
Look, I told her I didn't want to get serious.
That's what falling for each other's all about.
Look, I can't afford to get tied down, and that's fine.
Well, there was a time when a man was in love with a young girl. He didn't care if she had tuppence in the bank.
Money's got nothing to do with it.
Well, we don't need your help anyway. Well, now, I'm getting me compensation, and Dora's getting her mother's house, so we can do without you. And bloody thing, no, I don't need your help, and neither does Dora. Good riddance.
Lizzie! Lizzie!
Chrissy, you want to talk about it? I've got something that'll buck you up. If Jude did, like I said, the stuff should be in the garden by now.
How'd she get back in? You're only allowed one visit.
I know that, but Jude would do anything for me. She would have managed. It's risky leaving it there too long. I've got to get it tonight. But I need your help, Chrissy. They won't let me out, but you're just back from hospital. I figured out a way we can get it B and get the others on side too.
Where's your friend hidden it then?
Just before you get to reception. There's the white bench opposite that, under the bushes.
It's too near tea. They won't let me out now.
Want a bet?
Hey, Carol! Caroline!
Yes?
In here for a sec.
That's the bait. All we need now is a fish.
Oh, Chrissy's not feeling very well. She needs a bit of fresh air. Could you get Mr. Fletcher?
Well, of course, but can't you?
Oh, he's got it in for us. But he'd listen to you.
Just got to sit down for a bit.
I'll be okay.
Did you speak to Paul Reed?
Yes. I didn't think Michael would want to see me. Unless he just wants to gloat.
Well, the main thing is, he's agreed to testify.
Probably to make me feel indebted to him. He wouldn't be doing it out of the goodness of his heart.
But if your husband knew what was going on all the time, why didn't he try and do something about it?
Him? He was just as scared as Mum was. I tried to get her to leave him. I don't know whether it was pride or maybe she still loved him. Dad changed so much after his accident. He used to be so strong, I suppose. Oh, feeling better?
Yeah, I've had all the fresh air I need. Thanks, Mr. Fletcher.
All right, come on.
Yeah, it's really broken her up. Still, she's lucky she didn't lose it, no thanks to Ben.
But how could she do that to another woman?
Oh, you get all types in here.
And at least they put her now where she can't hurt anyone else.
But for how long?
Stop trying to make out she's some raving lunatic.
Isn't she?
What are you trying to do?
Nothing. Bea might have you bluffed back. But she's not as great as you think she is. You'll find out.
Well, come on, clean it up and get yourself another plate. What a mess.
everywhere.